Hey guys, good morning. Coach Jen T here. Today we have some healthy Halloween tips. And this is not just for yourself, but it could be for if you have a family, if you have kids, or if you're attending a Halloween party. It's important to like keep those healthy habits in the back of your mind and know that like nothing's restricted, but you want to just be mindful with the treats. And we see an abundance of like Halloween candy this time of year. So today we're just going to go over 10 healthy Halloween tips for not just you, but for your family, for the Halloween parties you might attend. So number one is to choose healthier treats. Now, this doesn't have to be all or nothing, but like you can do things like dark chocolate, fruit snacks, or nuts for the kids. You can do applesauce pouches. Just having that option, let's say you're doing like a little Halloween bag and assembling it for your kiddos or for the kids that are going to be trick-or-treating, you can put in like, you know, a couple pieces of candy and then something that's maybe just a little healthier. So those are just some ideas if you do want to incorporate healthier options. You know, also things like animal crackers or little pretzel packets or goldfish or things like that, just some sort of cracker to go along with all of the added sugars from the candy, just to supplement with that. Also like dried fruit is also a great one. Number two is to practice portion control. So when you get lots of candy, I really am curious how people do it when they take their kids trick-or-treating. Because like, are you the type of parent that, or when you were a kid, were you allowed to eat, you know, all of your candy that you wanted to until your heart was fulfilled with all the candy you could eat? Or were you the type that were like, you were a little more, had some rules on how much candy you could eat in the night? I'm curious to know what other people did. For me, when I was little, it was whatever I wanted, whenever I wanted. I think I was eating candy right up until midnight when I was a kid, just like, and like eating it all. Some tactics that I've heard from like my friend Lacey, I really liked her idea. You know, when you have little kids, they don't understand self-regulation with candy, because it's delicious, it's highly palatable, it's really easy to eat. And especially if you find your favorite. So she used to say like during trick-or-treating night, it's kind of like a not a free-for-all, but like relax with letting your kids have the sugar, no problem, right? But she used to say every three houses, she'd let her kid like pick out a piece of candy to eat during the trick-or-treating. Or, you know, after the actual holiday of trick-or-treating is over, letting your kids pick like maybe three pieces of candy from their bag that they can have that day. And we're talking for younger kids, like I have a 7-year-old, they just have less self-regulation. So like letting them pick out three, you know, for the day and they can have it whenever they want. I'm curious to know your thoughts there, but that's just for like the more younger kids. And then eventually, like when you have teenagers or older kids, you know, free for all, do what you want, but it's a good lesson sometimes. Like when you don't have the self-regulation yet, you learn it very quickly if you eat so much Halloween candy that you feel sick. So just something to keep in mind. You can also like, you can freeze treats if you want to. Like Halloween candy can be like frozen. Unfortunately, I think Halloween candy tastes better frozen, like the Charleston Chews. But you can also donate treats, I remember a long time ago, I had like a challenge and like everyone donated some Halloween candy that was like left over or half their bag. And we like put it in a big box and shipped it for like, treats for troops or something like that. People overseas, soldiers overseas, like just send them some candy, give them a little bit of the Halloween spirit. The next thing is number three, you can also, as you're assembling treats, or like I'm hosting a Halloween party tonight actually for kids. It's gonna be crazy. I'm very excited, but also along with the candy, having like non-candy treats offered too. Things like stickers are a big one, fake tattoos. I bought some little Halloween bracelets. What else did I have here? Like small kind of toys, like mini slinkies. The tattoos are a big one. And I don't know what else I have. Oh, I've got some Halloween straws that are super cute. They're like the twirly straws, but they have like a little Halloween themed like logo or stick on it. Super cute. And then it also lets the kids know which straw is theirs. I don't know what else I have. I do have candy, of course, but having the non-candy options is also just like a really fun thing. If you guys have any other ideas of non-food items to put in like treat bags, let me know what you come up with. Number four, if you're celebrating the holiday, the Halloween, whatever, parties, make sure you're staying active, especially for kids. Like, it's easy to sit down at the like table and just do nothing but munch on snacks, of course, but like keep the kids active, do something fun. We personally like doing like a scavenger hunt outside, which we're doing this year, to like find treats, find candy. And then we're also doing like limbo and a dance party and karaoke and like tons of fun stuff for the kids to keep them active. And you can stay active with your kiddos and make it really fun, showing them that you can have like fun without revolving around food all the time. Number five is be choosy with your treats. Just because it's there doesn't mean you need to eat it. Ask yourself what's truly worth it to you. For some people, it might be the Reese's peanut butter cups or some kind of Halloween candy you look forward to every year. Maybe it's a candy corn, maybe it's not. But be choosy with your treats, and maybe you're not necessarily, you know, going to town on the candy, but you know, if there's that homemade treat that someone makes every Halloween season, I say go for that. Like, that's super like delicious and something to truly enjoy. So ask yourself ahead of time what's truly worth it to you. You know, ditch what doesn't matter to you and like enjoy the things that, or save the things you really want to savor. Number six is make sure your costumes, if you're dressing up or kiddos are dressing up, make sure they're just comfortable to move in. Number seven is to focus on fun, not just food. We already talked about that. Pumpkin painting is a really fun one. Pumpkin carving. The scavenger hunt for us is going to be so fun. I found like a template. If anybody wants it, let me know and I can copy and paste it to you. It's like 20 scavenger hunt clues and they're all really spooky. So it's fun for the kids. And they like have to find number one, then they have to go find number two because there's a clue on where it's going to be. And then at the end, there's like a treasure and they have to work as a team to go find that treasure. And then they can split the whatever is in the treasure box. Number eight, plan ahead. So if you are going to a Halloween party and you're not sure what's going to be offered for yourself personally, you can always offer to bring like a healthier dish. You can be like, hey, I'm going to bring the veggies, or you're going to bring like a nice protein packed appetizer. Just knowing, you know, planning ahead, knowing that you have something there. If you are an adult and you're going to a Halloween party and you're planning on like drinking some adult beverages, make sure that you don't go attend that party on an empty stomach. Super important. For me personally, I host parties. I can't let the day get away from me without really fueling up on like protein and veggies and having good whole balanced meals with lots of whole foods and drinking lots of water through the day. But you don't want to go in hungry, especially if you are planning on drinking like an alcoholic beverage or two, and you want to make sure that you're just staying hydrated and you want to make sure that you are feeling good. If you're hungry going into it, let the day get away from you, which is easy to do if you're busy. You are going to regret it and probably not feel great the next day. Number nine is to hydrate. Kind of goes ahead with planning ahead. Drink lots of water. If you're attending like an adult party, also if your kids are trick-or-treating on Halloween, make sure they're staying hydrated, because when you're eating like extra candy and sugar, you want to make sure that you're staying hydrated to help like digest and flush that stuff out. And then of course, drinking lots of water can also help you feel full, so that when you're, you know, tempted with all the delicious foods at like a Halloween style buffet style, you're like less tempted to like overeat because you're full, because you drank plenty of water. And then number 10, the last and best one, is practice mindful eating. We just ran through a 6-week challenge, which I think is finishing up like in a day or two. But one of the things that we really focused on was mindful eating, slowing down enjoying and savoring every bite of what you're eating, but listen to your true hunger cues. Like, you want to eat until you're satisfied and not overly stuffed, and that's naturally just going to help you like portion control things out and reduce calories a little bit so you're not going overboard. And that goes for whether you're eating like a healthy meal, a salad, whatever it is, or if you are eating like candy, if you're in a situation where you're like, you know, if you're at work and there's a candy dish or someone brings in a treat, just ask yourself, like, how hungry am I? And how worth it is it? If it's totally worth it and you're feeling like you want a piece of something, just like savor every bite, the flavors, the textures, things like that. And then you just will find that the slower you eat your treats, the less you're going to be likely to go overboard and you're going to feel satisfied on less overall. That is it for Halloween tips, you guys. Please comment if you watch this. I'd like to know your biggest takeaway. And if you guys are interested in coaching or you want to know more about my coaching programs, feel free to send me a message, reach out to me. I'm happy to see where you're at, what your goals are, and how we can get you to what your goals are. Have a good day.